What a great and privileged people we are, for whom the God of heaven and the earth becomes our own. And blessed is the man who makes God as his own, who comes to be with us and celebrates him. If we miss him, we miss life. If we have him, the heaven has us. We read in Psalm 84, verse 5 to 7, it says, what joy for those whose strength comes from the Lord. Blessed is the man whose strength is the Lord. What's our strength? Psalm 84 says, what joy for those whose strength comes from the Lord, who have set their minds on a pilgrimage of Jerusalem. Blessed is the man whose strength is the Lord, at the same time who is aware this life is a pilgrimage. This is not my permanent home. The people on this earth are not my permanent companions, including my husband or my wife or anybody. Know the truth. Truth will set you free. Not only we are called to set us free, to celebrate life, to become children of the Lord himself. What joy for those whose strength comes from the Lord, who has set their minds. Here the word says, mind will not simply accept. You have to set your mind. You have to set your mind. Blessed are those who is busy. The whole world is busy with the world. But blessed are those who are busy in setting their mind, directing their mind, guiding their mind to where it belongs to. Verse 6 says, when they walk through the valley of weeping, life is made up good and bad. They will be walking through valley of weeping, but those who set their minds on God, on truth, and those whose strength is the Lord, what will happen to them? The word of God says, when they walk through the valley of weeping, it will become a place of refreshing springs. What? Walking through the valley and it becomes springs. Life. David compares his walking in the valley to death. When I walk in the valley of death, he says, in the valley, all the water will be just lying there. All poisonous snakes will be there. And the water will be poisonous because unused to water, lying there for many years. But here for the man whose strength is the Lord, who has set his mind on the things of the Lord, for him, even in the valley, God will prepare springs. He will be weeping. His situations will be like that of weeping and walking in the valley. But he will find it will become a place of refreshing springs, and the autumn rains will clothe it with blessings. They will continue to grow stronger, and each of them will appear before God in Jerusalem. I like to quote one more quotation for you before we go into the reflection, where Saint Peter says in the book of Acts chapter 2, he says, verse 38 onwards, each of you must repent of your sin and return to God and be baptized in the name of the Lord for the forgiveness of your sin, and then you will receive the gift of Holy Spirit. God gives the gift of Holy Spirit who see their God. And who can bring life to them? He is the only one who can give. I give you one more quotation for you. Chapter 3 of Acts, verse 19. Peter said, "Now repent for your sins and return to God. Learn to see your God, not yourself or your life." This is the secret. Learn to see your God, who is the author of your life, who has brought to you for a purpose. Move with him, and all that of God will move with you. Repentance means once again setting your mind, taking your mind away from the world and away from yourself, and to set it on your God. That's why Peter says, it's a beautiful word of God. He says, now if you set your mind on God and turn to God, number one, your sin will be wiped away. Verse 20 says, then times of refreshment will come from the presence of the Lord. Time of refreshment that comes from the Lord will become yours. And he will again send you Jesus, the appointed Messiah, in the person of the Holy Spirit. Yes. That's why the great man, even amidst many struggle, Job, in chapter 12, verse 10 onwards, he says, for the life of every living thing is in God's hand. For the life of every living thing is in God's hand. And the breath of every human being, the ear tests the words it hears. Just as the mouth distinguishes between foods. People in the world think Socrates is a great man or Plato is the great man, and they go on study about all this. Bible says wisdom is given by God. Wisdom belongs to the aged, and understanding to the world. They all write what they experienced in their life. But verse 13, but true wisdom and power are found in God. Counsel and understanding are his. If he holds back the rain, the earth becomes a desert. If he releases the water, they flood the earth. Yes, strength and wisdom are his. Deceivers holding on to themselves, thinking that they are building their legacy on this earth. Buying, selling, doing this and that. The word of God says, deceivers and deceived are both in his power. Hallelujah.
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 That's why today's first reading says, when God calls you, don't harden your heart, throwing your heart to this broken world and lose yourself. Look at the Lord. Walk with him. Remember your forefathers. God led them in a mighty way. He showed them the power of God and love of God by delivering them from the hands of Pharaoh, leading them through Red Sea, providing them manna in the desert, living water from the rock, leading them with the clouds and fire of heaven. But one doesn't like to set the mind on the mind. If you are not busy in setting your mind on the Lord and on the truth, you will be busy with yourself. Who is loving me? Who is supporting me? Who is making me big? I am big. You will lose yourself. That is the tragedy of man. And the Lord says, your forefathers, when I was leading them, instead of looking at me and walk, they looked left and side. Some people's mind is always very busy. What is happening here? What is happening? All news collecting. Stupid fellow, collecting the news will destroy you. All curiosity. What will happen? What is happening? Who is talking? What is what? And you lose yourself. Focus on God. Our forefathers are busy and curious. They saw people are dancing, the ladies with cloth, without cloth. And some are drinking alcohol. They went. And they became, the heroes became zeros. And they were all bitten by snakes. Their bodies were thrown in the desert. Even then, people don't learn from the truth. Your mind, if you don't set on the Lord, on the truth, that He is our God, He is our strength, He is our life. Why are you getting upset, getting angry, getting losing your mood? No. Be alert. Rejoice in the Lord. Celebrate the Lord. He is with you. Even if you are in a worst situation, the Bible says, Gospel today, like the situation of a leper. Leper means the world called him a cursed man, a rejected man. He has no right to meet any other human being. If at all he has to meet, he has to ring the bell and say, a leper is coming, and standing there and ask, what does he want? They will keep some rice or some money. He has, after they are moving, he is to go and collect it. Here is a man who knows Jesus, who understands Jesus and sets his mind on Jesus. He goes, kneels before Jesus and says, if you desire, you can heal me. I know who you are. The whole world is busy in finding themselves. Here is a leper who finds his master, his God. And the master said, blessed are you, man. You have set your mind not on what the world has done to you. Some are very busy. They did to me like that. When I was a small child, somebody did to me. How long you will go on talk about your past hurts and memories? Return to God, the healer of yours. Get healed and move on healing others. There are thousands of people who are hurt like you. Is it God called you to connect yourself, to think of yourself as a wounded man and to die with the wounded world? No. Don't go on play with your life. Don't waste your life. Don't waste your time. Get up. God is calling you. Set your mind on truth. Celebrate your life. Look at your mouth. Why are you so sad, moody fellow? Come out of your moodiness. Celebrate life. Be happy. The world is full of sadness. He trusted and chose you to be a person of courage, love, and celebrate. Lead everybody. That is possible only when you set the Lord before you and see the Lord in everything that happens in your life. Nothing to worry when your God is your Lord. If you give Him, He will have all your worries. Close your eyes for a moment and pray. The leper found the Lord, and the Lord said, I desire, I love such people. I love, I wish. He went and embraced him. Today, how long you are praying? Why are you not getting the embrace of Jesus? Because you are carrying yourself even in prayer. Your prayer problems as prayers. When are you going to celebrate the Lord? When are you going to set your mind on the God who goes before you? Celebrate Him. And life is yours. you are the one. Blessed are those, what joy for those whose strength comes from the Lord, who have set their minds on the Lord and considering their life as a pilgrimage. When they walk through the valley of weeping, even there they will become a place of refreshing springs. The autumn rain will clothe it with a blessing. They will continue to grow stronger, and each of them will appear before God in Jerusalem. O Lord, God of heaven's armies, some depend on horses and others depend on the chariots, but we celebrate the Lord. Psalm 20 verse 7. Jesus said to Mary Magdalene, who had like this leper who was searching for Jesus. Peter came, John came to the graveyard, to the tomb of Jesus. They were looking for the empty grave, and they saw empty grave. They saw the cloth and went away. But Mary Magdalene, though her past was a sinful past, she experienced the love of Jesus. Now she was looking for Jesus. And so, when she went alone, when you look for God, you don't get frightened. Whether it is night or day, whether it is a tomb or heaven. She went inside alone, a lady, and found the angels. She heard the good news. Jesus is risen. What a joy! As she was coming out, Jesus himself was there, asking, whom are you looking? I look for my beloved. We have buried him. I don't know where they have kept. You give me, I will take him. What? What stupid are you talking, lady? 3 days are gone, that body will stink. No, my love for him is stronger than. Let it be any stinking, I want him. Even though anything, even if it is a dead body, I want him. I want him. I want him. Jesus said to her, Mary, go and give the good news. I am going before you. Blessed are those who can see me, who can build their lives on me, who can make their mourning into joy. I hate people who are mourning, who are depressed, showing their face to the broken world as though there are not enough people. Jesus said to them, go, give the good news. I am going before them. Today, let's celebrate that Jesus, you are a God who goes before us. You are a God who walks along with us, breaking every barriers and leading us to glory. Hallelujah! Hallelujah! Hallelujah!
Hallelujah!
Let's celebrate. You are a God who goes before us. You are a God who walks along with us. You are a God who goes before us. You are a God who walks along with us. You go before us to break all the barriers. You go before us
to break all the barriers.
You walk along with us to guide our steps. You walk along with us to guide us. Alleluia. 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 Your name is El Shaddai, your name is all powerful.
Your name is
El Roy, the one who sees all my life.
Your name is El Roy,
the one who sees all my life. Alleluia, 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 alleluia. You are a God who goes before us. You are a God who walks along with us. You are a God who goes before us. You are a God who walks along with us. You go before us to break all the barriers.
You go before us to break all the barriers.
You walk along with us to guide our steps.
You walk along with us to guide us.
Alleluia, 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 alleluia. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. We praise you, Lord, we worship you, we adore you, Lord, hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Let's pray to the Lord. Let's close our eyes and make our reflection into prayer, that we may go deep into the truth and set ourselves on the Lord and set ourselves free. Don't roam around your weakness, your past history. Come out. May He heal you as He healed the leper, and celebrate life with Jesus. Let's pray.